We believe Christine Blasey Ford, and we still believe Anita Hill.
Dear Professor Ford.
Dear Professor Ford.
We know how difficult it is to stand up to powerful people.
We want to thank you for publicly sharing your story of sexual violence.
We applaud your courage in coming forward
for the public good, and we will be with you as you face the inevitable backlash.
Do we have to believe all the women? That was the question I posed before.
I'd like to believe all the women.
You'd like to, but will you or do you have to?
I think we should.
What the hell did you just say?
I think we should.
I personally choose to always believe the women.
Does she know how completely ignorant that sounds? That'd be like saying, I personally choose to believe all the long-haired white male hippies.
I personally choose to always believe the women.
I personally choose to believe all the brothers.
It's the men in this country, and I just want to say to the men of this country, just shut up and step up. Do the right thing.
Shut up. Step up. Excuse me, honey? What was that third thing I was supposed to do?
Do the right thing, you idiot!
Oh, that's right. Okay. I'm gonna be a good man. I'm gonna be a good man. I'm gonna believe everything women say. Always. For everything.
I personally choose to always believe the women.
I personally choose to believe all the soy boys.
I believe women.
Women need to believe. They don't lie about rape.
They don't lie about rape.
What the hell is wrong with you people?
I believe women.
I believe Dr. Ford.
I believe women.
I believe Dr. Ford.
I believe in Christine. I believe in women.
Oh yeah, heck yeah. I always choose to believe the women. Okay, but what's your foundation or basis for that belief? I'll be right there, sweetums. I gotta go, my wife's calling me.
I personally choose to always believe the women.
Always?
Always.
Really? Always?
Always.
Okay, but it sounds a little NPC to me.
Always believe the women.
How about this? I personally choose to be convinced and swayed by the evidence. Guys, here's today's video.
You can believe what you want. The goal of this video is not to tell you what you should or shouldn't believe. But I am telling you that if you choose to believe one person over another without weighing or even considering any evidence or questioning the lack of evidence, you're as nutty as a squirrel turd. And the non-playable character meme fits you well as you regurgitate the well-worn lines of your multimedia masters. Many reputations have been marred and the lives of countless people have been ruined because somebody chose to be malicious and evil and lie about another person. These are just some examples.
An Edmonton cab driver is suing four female passengers for accusations they made against him. The girls tried to accuse the man of sexual assault, a move he says could have ruined his life. Scott Frolick has more.
Sonar Yesa actually had the camera hanging from his rearview mirror in his cab, had signs around the cab saying, "You are on camera, I am recording." Despite that, when the girls got into the cab outside a local bar, they started to want to smoke, which is illegal. Sonar pointed that out and said, "You cannot light up, it'll be a $500 fine." There was some swear words thrown around. At that point, he got to the destination the girls wanted. It was a $13 fare. The girls said, "We're not going to pay." He threatened to call the police. That's when the girls said to the bystanders nearby that the cab driver had tried to assault them. They called police. But I want you to listen and watch the girls inside the cab. You can see some of the videotape for yourself. Here it is.
Get on radio.
You up there?
No, you
what? Now, after the police arrived at the scene, they talked with everybody involved, and that's when the cab driver said, "I've got tape of this incident. Come take a look." The police did. They looked at the tape, they reviewed the tape, and they said there would be no charges. They had no evidence of any kind of assault, sexual or otherwise.
Wait a minute. I thought women didn't lie about rape. At least that's the BS this guy's trying to feed us.
They don't lie about rape.
I personally choose to always believe the women.
That there would be no charges. They had no evidence of any kind of assault, sexual or otherwise. Here, there are no charges. But that's when Sonar Yesa said, well, what about my reputation? Had I not had this tape, he told me, I would have been probably charged. I would have lost my marriage. I could have lost and would have lost my job just based on the charges, no matter what happened after that. So he wanted the girls charged. Police decided, though, to close down the case, saying there wasn't enough evidence either way. So now he's looking for a civil remedy, and he is looking for $60,000 in damages from those girls.
What kind of person do you have to be to concoct a lie like this? A lie that would have abiding and horrific consequences in the life of an innocent man for the rest of his life. Here's the next example.
True, we need to know now, and we need to stop the progression of this whole thing from getting worse, because it's just going to get bigger and bigger.
And only on 7 News, this police interview with a Fort Collins woman. She was later convicted for making phony rape accusations.
They don't lie about rape.
And the man she accused was arrested and put in jail 1 year ago today.
That I've been given do not match evidence.
This is exclusive video of her police interview. As Toth sat in jail, her story fell apart.
I'm not telling you to drop charges. I want to know the facts about what happened.
Bennett later convicted of making it all up.
They don't lie about rape.
I believe women.
She was sentenced to 35 days in jail, then an ankle monitor and probation.
I personally choose to always believe the women.
Later convicted of making it all up. She was sentenced to 35 days in jail, then an ankle monitor and probation.
I don't feel that's justice.
Toth says he's the one who's been punished. The Army National Guardsman lost his civilian job and was out of work for nearly 6 months after the arrest.
I've been behind on my car payment ever since.
He has his friends, but the emotional pain is still there.
I feel like I'm incapable to actually trust a woman again.
He says it's telling his story that's helping him heal.
Giving me the opportunity to share it gives me the opportunity to clear my name, because I still feel like my name is not cleared.
Courier is demanding an apology after he was wrongfully accused in the attack. News Center 5's Rondella Richardson tells us why it's up to him if he wants his name removed from documents linking him to that case.
This could have been prevented.
The 26-year-old tax accountant wrongfully accused would have to go to court to have charges expunged from his record, as Ross Courier is still waiting for a formal apology from law enforcement. He's fighting for his reputation. Police arrested him last month for a sexual assault in the North End within minutes after the victim mistakenly told police he was her attacker. His attorney says he wasn't questioned and went right to jail.
We got them down there in short order, and the suspect was taken into custody.
Today, police won't comment on apologizing, only saying for the district attorney to drop the charges speaks for itself.
Now, I have a professional license to practice in my industry. That was almost taken from me at 26. Don't you consider that a bit of a death sentence?
Yet his name is far from clear.
Google it. See what you find.
I never gave her the benefit of the doubt. If you looked at the evidence in its totality, it was clear from very early on in this case that this was indeed a bogus case. And Jane, I think both you and I can agree that all the charges should be dropped. This is absolutely unbelievable. On the night in question, just that night alone, she had several different versions of events. In one version of events that night, she claimed she was only groped and not even raped. She changed the number of attackers. In the photo lineup, she identified different people. She identified one of the people as having a mustache who didn't even have a mustache. This whole case has been wrought with irregularities and nonsense and deceptions. Mike Nifong keeping exculpatory evidence away from the defense. You're talking about a guy that did 70 press interviews, used it to get reelected. There was never any real evidence against these players. The DNA didn't match on any count in any way, in any capacity this entire time. You have absolutely no reason to believe these players committed this crime. One of the players has a solid alibi during the time the crime was supposed to have occurred. You've got all this stuff. I cannot think of one case of equivalent or near profile in the United States of America where there's been so little reason for three people or one person or anybody to be brought to trial.
This is insanity.
And I'll say this, the one person, again, who without question has behaved in an unethical, immoral, and sinister fashion is District Attorney Mike Nifong. He's pursued a case not because of the evidence, but in spite of the evidence.
I'm just trying to imagine ruining somebody's life like this. The liar gets to walk around carefree and live her life knowing that an innocent person she lied about is sitting in prison with no freedom, probably being abused and raped, and estranged from his family, all because somebody decided to be ultra evil. Leave your thoughts about this for the world and the Google Thought Police in the comment section below. What do you think about these people who brainlessly push the idea that women or anybody just needs to be believed no matter what? If you guys want to support this channel, grab a hard-hitting shirt or support the work on Patreon or PayPal. Also, make sure you sign up to my email list through my website and connect with me on censorship-free BitChute, DTube, Gab, and Minds.com. One way or another, we're going to rid ourselves of all this censorship. I'll see you guys in the next video.
That though, I mean, there was the discouragement to come forward, but now we're at a point where it seems like people feel comfortable going forward. And didn't we kind of see this coming when people started saying you have to believe the women no matter what? I mean, a red light went off in a lot of people's minds where you said, wait a second, it doesn't make sense to believe any group of people no matter what they say based on the group that they are.